Saudi Arabia oil attacks, U.S. to send troops to Saudi Arabia. The U.S. has announced plans to send forces to Saudi Arabia in the wake of attacks against the country's oil infrastructure. Secretary of Defense Mark Esper told reporters the deployment would be defensive in nature. Total troop numbers have not yet been decided. Yemen's Iran-backed Houthi rebels have claimed responsibility for the attacks against two oil facilities last week. But the U.S. and Saudi Arabia have both blamed Iran itself. Earlier on Friday, however, President Trump announced highest-level sanctions against Iran while signaling he wanted to avoid military conflict. "I think the strong person approach, and the thing that does show strength, would be showing a little bit of restraint," he told reporters in the Oval Office. "The fresh sanctions will focus on Iran's central bank and its sovereign wealth fund," Mr. Trump said. What did the Pentagon say? Mr. Esper made the announcement alongside the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General Joseph Dunford Jr., on Friday. "Saudi Arabia and the United Arab Emirates requested assistance," Mr. Esper said. "The forces will focus on boosting air and missile defenses, and the U.S. will accelerate the delivery of military equipment to both nations." Jen Dunford called the deployment moderate and said it would not number in the thousands. He gave no further details about the type of forces to be sent. According to the New York Times, when reporters asked Mr. Esper if military strikes on Iran were still being considered, the defense secretary responded, "That's not where we are right now." What happened in Saudi Arabia? Strikes hit the Abqaiq oil facility and the Khurais oil field in Saudi Arabia a week ago, affecting the global oil supply. On Wednesday, the kingdom's defense ministry showed off what it says are the remains of drones and cruise missiles proving Iranian involvement. "The country is, however, still working to know exactly the launch point," a spokesman said. The U.S. also alleges Iran is responsible. Senior officials have told U.S. media outlets they had evidence the attacks originated in the south of Iran. Iran has repeatedly denied any role in the strikes, with President Hassan Rouhani calling the attacks a reciprocal act by the Yemeni people. U.S. is in denial if it thinks the Yemeni victims of 4.5 years of the worst war crimes wouldn't do all to strike back, Iran's Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif tweeted. On Wednesday, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo had called the strikes an act of war. Mr. Zarif warned on Twitter that Iran had no desire for war, but we will not hesitate to defend ourselves. What's the background to all this? The Houthis have repeatedly launched rockets, missiles and drones at populated areas in Saudi Arabia. They are in conflict with a Saudi-led coalition which backs a president who the rebels had forced to flee when the Yemeni conflict escalated in March 2015. Iran is the regional rival of Saudi Arabia and an opponent of the U.S., which pulled out of a treaty aimed at limiting Tehran's nuclear program after Mr. Trump took power. U.S.-Iran tensions have risen markedly this year. The U.S. said Iran was behind attacks on two oil tankers in the Gulf in June and July, as well as on another four in May. Tehran rejected the accusations in both cases.